Hello everyone, welcome you all in another lecture of structural analysis. We are looking into influence line diagram, and in the previous two classes we have seen the derivation of maximum shear force, reaction and the bending moment, and we have calculated the maximum shear force on the given section, negative and the positive. And both the lectures, the link of the both the lectures I have mentioned in the description of this video lecture. So go through that and you will get understand the very new topic which we are taking in this class, that is the maximum shear force in the girder. Myself, Professor Asif Beg, Assistant Professor, Civil Engineering Department, Tulsiramji Gaikwad Patel College of Engineering. Now we have to calculate the maximum shear force in the girder. So we will draw the girder, which is given as having length of 15 meter. Here we are talking about the maximum shear force in the girder. Hence we did not need to mention the section in this girder. Okay, as section C is given here at a distance of 4 meter from A and 11 meter from B. But that C we did not need to mention at this point because we are talking about whole girder. Now the load is given 40 kilonewton, 50, 60, 60 kilonewton and 20 kilonewton at a distance of 1.5 meter. This is 1.5 meter, this is 2 meter and this is 1 meter. Now, as we are talking about the maximum shear force, so maximum shear force will be act either at A support or B support. So to calculate shear force at A and shear force at B, we have to put this strain on the girder. So first we will calculate the maximum shear force at A. So the whole train will be situated in the girder. So the load which is situated at A will be this 20 kilonewton, because the whole train will be at this girder. So the last load will be at this point, at this A. So whether this 20 kilonewton load will give us the maximum shear force on girder at A or not, that we have to check first. So we are having that logical equation, that is load rolled off divided by succeeding span should be greater than remaining load divided by span. So we will take this 20 kilonewton load. So 20 kilonewton divided by succeeding span is 1.5, should be greater than sum of load 60 plus 60 plus 50 plus 40 divided by total span is 15 kilonewton. So 20 divided by 1.5 we are getting 13.33, and this value we are getting as 14. So this condition is false. So we will go for trial 2. Trial 2, the next load is 60. So 60 we are putting divided by succeeding span is 1.5. This should be greater than the remaining load 60 plus 50 plus 40 divided by 15. So this is 40. And this value we are getting as, I think this is 10. So this condition is satisfying. This condition is satisfying. Hence we will keep this 60 kilonewton load on this A support. So we will put this 60 over there. Then next 60 at this point. Then 50. Then 40. And this 20 kilonewton meter load is 20 kilonewton load will be out of the girder, hence the effect of this will not come into picture. So we will not mentioning this 20 kilonewton load at this point. Now this is 1.5, this is 2, this is 1. So the remaining distance will be, we will calculate 1 plus 2, that is 3. This is 1.5, this is 4.5. So remaining distance 15 minus this will be 10.5 meter. So the remaining distance is 10.5 meter. So what we will do, we will calculate this influence line diagram for RA. So at this point RA will be 1. Okay, now we will make section of loading. This is, if this is Y1, the Y1 is equals to 1, then this will be Y2, Y3 and Y4. This thing we have to calculate. Okay, so first we will calculate Y1. Y1 we know that is 1. Then we will calculate the value of Y2. So Y2 is equals to 1 divided by 15 multiplied with this Y2 remaining distance. Okay, so this distance is 15 minus 1.5. So this will be equals to 13.5. So the value of Y2 we are getting as 0.9 meter, or 0.9 only. Okay, this is this having no unit. Okay, now we will calculate the value of Y3. So this is 1 divided by 15 multiplied with 15 minus this 3.5. So the value is 11.5, and the value of Y3 we are getting as 23 by 30. Okay, now value of Y4 we will calculate. Value of Y4, so value of Y4 will be 1 by 15 into 10.5. The remaining distance is 10.5, so value of Y4 will be 0.7. So the value of Y1, value of Y2, value of Y3 and Y4 we know. We will multiply that value with this load, 60, 60, 50 and 40 respectively. So I am doing the calculation at this point. So maximum shear force in girder, will be equals to 60 into 1 plus 60 into 0.9 plus 50 into 23 by 30 plus Y4 is 0.7 and the magnitude is 40. So 40 into 0.7. So the value we are getting as 180.33. This value we are getting as 180.33 kilonewton. Okay, so this calculation we will done. Maximum shear force in girder while keeping the load on A we have calculated. Similarly, we will do the calculation by keeping whole this whole train on B, and we will compare these two value, maximum shear force, either we are getting this maximum, or by keeping this load on B, that value we will calculate, and we will check that is that value maximum or this one maximum. Okay, and whatever will be the maximum value, that will be the maximum shear force in the girder. Okay, so now we will do the calculation for RB. So we will draw the girder A and B. This is having length 15 meter, and we know that the load is given 40, 50, 60, 60 and 20 at a distance of 1.5, 1.5, 2 meter and 1 meter. Now we have to calculate the maximum shear force in girder by keeping all this load condition on B. So very first load will be at B is 40 kilonewton. So we will keep this load on 40. So we will check whether this 40 kilonewton or other load due to other load, the shear force whichever we are getting, that is maximum. So we will apply the same condition, that is load rolled off divided by succeeding span divided by, it should be greater than sum of the remaining load divided by span. So we will take first load is 40. So 40 divided by succeeding span is 1, should be greater than the remaining load, that is 50 plus 60 plus 60 plus 20 divided by the total span is 50. So this is 40, should be greater than the value which we are getting as (12.67), and this is satisfying. So by keeping the load of 40 kN, we will get the maximum shear force at girder, in girder on B. Okay, so we will keep this load on B. This is 40, this is 50, this is 60, this is 60, and this is 20. This is 1 meter, 2 meter, 1.5 meter, 1.5 meter. So the remaining distance will be equals to 9 meter. 15 minus this one, will be, we will get this 9 meter. Now we will draw the influence line diagram at B. So this at B, this is 1, this is 0. Now we will mark this point. Okay, now this is equals to y1, y2, y3 and y4. This value we know. Okay, this is 1 meter. So 40 into 1, we will directly do this and we will calculate y1, y2, y3, y4 by using the symmetry of triangle. Okay, so very first we will calculate the value of y1. So y1 is y1 is equals to 1 by 15 into, this remaining distance is 14 meter, so this is 14, so this will be equals to 14 by 15. Okay, we can write this value. Okay, now we will calculate the value of y2. So this is 1 by 15 into, this is 15 minus 3 meter, that is 12 meter, this is 12. So we are getting the value of point 12 by 15. So value we are getting as 0.8. Now we will calculate the value of y3. So y3, 1 by 15 into 12 minus again this 1.5, so this will be 10.5. so 10.5 multiply, we will get the value of 0.7. then y4 we will calculate, 1 by 15 into 9 is equals to, that value we are getting as 0.6. so y1, y2, y3 and y4 we have calculated. Now we will calculate the maximum shear force. Maximum shear force in girder, and this is equals to 60 into, sorry, we will start the calculation from this 40. So 40 into 1 plus 50 into 14 by 15 plus 60 into 0.8 plus 60 into 0.7 plus 20 into 0.6. Okay, now we will calculate this and we will get the value is equals to 188.67 kilonewton. And the previous value which we are getting is 180.33. So this is the maximum value and which is we are getting at B. So this will be the maximum shear force. So maximum shear force in girder is equals to 188.67 kilonewton. Now this is what how we have to calculate the maximum shear force in the girder. First we have to calculate the maximum shear force due to A while keeping the load on A, and similarly we have to do for B, and we have to compare both the value, and whatever will be the maximum value, that we have to take as maximum shear force in the girder. Okay, so due to this strain, the maximum shear force will be act at B by keeping the load of 40 kilonewton. So by this we will end up this second part, that is maximum shear force in girder. In the next video we will take the maximum bending moment under given load, or then we will shoot the video on maximum bending moment under given section, and the next after that we will shoot the video on calculation of maximum bending moment, and that is absolute maximum bending moment we will calculate. Thank you.